Hi Grizzlies, you're in for a treat today. We have a wonderful program in store as we celebrate Black History Month, and our theme this year is a journey through the arts. And I want to thank all of our talented students for being involved. I certainly want to thank Miss Brown, who always does an amazing job with our productions and our big performances. And I want to thank everyone that's involved today. I can't wait to see the final product. As a little different this year, we're not having our assembly with everybody together in the cafeteria like we usually do. Maybe next year, but this year we're going to do a virtual program. I'm so excited. Let's have a great program. Enjoy it. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Penelope Pasqualone, and I will be your MC for this program. Art is a highly diverse range of human activities engaged in creating visual and auditory performances that express the author's imaginative or technical skills and are intended to be appreciated for their beauty and emotional power. The arts are divided into 7 groups: architecture, sculpture, painting, literature, music, performing, and film stories. Today, our program will focus on literature, music, painting, and performing arts. Throughout our history, African Americans and other minorities have excelled in many areas, but the arts is an area where momentous achievements have been made. The first selection that you heard was entitled Lift Every Voice and Sing. It was performed by the 5th and 4th grade chorus with a solo by Kalea Jackson. The song Lift Every Voice and Sing was written by James Weldon Johnson and his brother Rosamond Johnson, who was born in Jacksonville, Florida. James Johnson was the first African American to pass the bar exam in the state of Florida. Along with songwriting skills, Johnson was also a poet, a diplomat, and an anthologist of African American culture. Our next presentation will be about visual art, and I will turn this over to our fabulous artist, Miss Mendenhall.
Thanks, Penelope. So, boys and girls, now you guys get to learn about African American artists who have made a huge difference in the art world. They speak volumes through their artwork, whether it is about race, feminism, injustices, or even hope. They speak volumes. So there are colors, lines, shapes, patterns, everything about their artwork. So I hope you really take the time to enjoy and learn about these next few artists. And you might even see some artworks that are in the art room. So enjoy.
The artist creates the material that we look back upon as part of history. I am Kahinde Wiley. I am known for my vibrant, large-scale paintings of African Americans posing as famous figures of Western art. I am the first African American to ever paint a presidential portrait, and the president was Barack Obama. Does not include an underlying art historical reference, but sunflowers in the background carry special meaning to Obama. The chrysanthemums, for example, are the official flower of Chicago. The jasmine evokes Hawaii, where he spent his childhood, and African blue lilies stand for his Kenyan father.
Amy Sherrod is an American painter. She paints portraits that show African Americans in everyday settings. She uses stage photographs of my subjects for my style and simple realism. Her work is only in shades of gray to make skin tones. She was the first woman to ever paint a presidential portrait. She was chosen by First Lady Michelle Obama to paint her official portrait for the National Portrait Gallery.
Kerry James Marshall is one of the most famous contemporary artist known for his portraits of black subjects. He mixes different time periods. He often paints events left out of history, born in Alabama during the Civil Rights Movement. His art is about his own history as well as others.
Faith Ringgold is an American artist who became famous for creating quilts that communicate her beliefs. While she was an art teacher, she created a series of paintings called American People, which showed the civil rights movement. She is also a successful children's book author and illustrator.
The artist Basquiat was an influence to African American artists who rose to success during the 1980s. Basquiat paintings are largely responsible for elevating to graffiti. Artists into the realm of the New York gallery scenes, his spray painted and scribbled words reference to everything from his Haitian and Puerto Rican heritage, political issues, famous people, and Bible verses. Yay.
Krista David's artwork is all about stories, using materials like magazines and newspaper. She cuts and pastes to make a collage. Her artwork shows her feelings about her own and other stories. She is amazing because she expresses her emotions in all of her work.
Music is certainly an important art form. From the beginning of an African's life in America, music was an intricate part of their lives. As time passed, African music was developed into many genres. Third grade recorder group will now perform an early form of African music, the spiritual. The song was important to the Underground Railroad and was entitled Wade in the Water.
Thank you.
Another song that was important to the Underground Railroad is entitled Follow the Drinking Gourd. It will be performed by the 4th and 5th grade chorus and the 4th grade ORF group. Many speeches written by African Americans have made their mark on history and will forever be part of our lives. One such speech is Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s I Have a Dream. Ms. Brown has written a song entitled A Song for Martin, and today Ms. Brown will perform her song along with Ms. Botini's class reciting Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s I Have a Dream.
And when we were uncertain about our future, 'twas a time when we didn't know what to expect. Came a man of strength and vigor to pursue his quest, to bring to us the freedom like all the rest. Martin was his name. He had a dream to make us all the same. And though he died for his beliefs, his dreams live on in those who knew him. This man we knew was Martin Luther King. Though times were hard, somehow we made it through. On the wings of dreams, imagine deep inside, that a nation built on freedom had to grant this fee, or to hide their shame and sorrow in their dignity. Martin was his name. He had a dream to make us all the same. And though he died for his beliefs, his dreams live on in those who knew him. This man we knew was Martin Luther King.
I say to you, so even though he's
I have a dream today that one day this nation will rise up and live up to everything on the screen. The world is just to be suffering, that all men are created.
I have a dream that one day all the red ears of Georgia, the sons of former slaves, and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit together at the table of brotherhood.
I have a dream that one day even the state of Mississippi, the state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will one day be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice.
I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character.
I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day every mouth shall be exalted and every human mouth shall be made low. The rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, no flesh shall see it together.
This is our hope, this is our faith, and I go back to the south. With this faith, we will be able to hear out the mountain and despair, a song of hope.
For this faith we will be able to transform the genuine discourse of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. This faith we will be able to work together to fight together, to struggle together, to stand up for freedom, building group and freedom.
This is the day when all of God's children will be able to sing with new meaning. My country tis of the sweet liberty of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrims' bride. From every mountainside let freedom ring. And if America is to be a great nation, this must become true.
Freedom ring from the prodigious hilltop of New Hampshire.
Let the freedom ring from the mighty mountains of South Dakota.
Let freedom ring from the heightening Alleghenies of Pennsylvania.
Let freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado.
Let freedom ring from the curvaceous slopes of California.
Let freedom ring from every hill and valley of Mississippi.
Let freedom ring from Lookout Mountain in Tennessee.
From every mountain side, let freedom ring.
And when this happens, when we allow freedom to ring, we'll let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city. We will be able to speak up that day, and all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the Negro spiritual.
Free at last! Free at last! Thank God Almighty, we are free at last!
Now it's up to us to carry on and see this through. Dr. King gave his unselfish life for you and you and you. We must first find the peace we need among ourselves. Then we're free to carry on the dream of Martin Luther King. Yes, we're free to carry on the dream of Martin Luther King.
One of America's most famous composers and singers is Stevie Wonder. The 4th and 5th grade chorus will now perform one of their favorite Stevie Wonder compositions, Sir Duke.
We all understand.
Miss Williams' fourth grade class will now perform a wonderful skit.
Amanda Gorman is an American poet and activist. Her work focuses on issues of oppression, feminism, race, and marginalization. She was the first person at the age of 22 to be named National Youth Poet Laureate in U.S. history. She set out to write a poem that would inspire hope and foster a sense of collective purpose. Today, we stand proud to recite her poem as one. Please sit back and relax and enjoy my fourth grade poets as they try to captivate our Gilchrist Elementary family as they recite The Hill We Climb with Amanda Gorman.
When day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade?
The loss we carry, a sea we must wade.
We've braved the belly of the beast.
We've learned that quiet isn't always peace.
In the norms and notions of what just is, isn't always just is.
And yet the dawn is ours before we know it.
Which somehow we've weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished.
We the successors of a country in a time where a skinny black girl descended from slaves and raised by a single mother can dream of becoming president.
Only to find herself reciting for one.
And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine. But that doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect.
We are striving to forge our union with purpose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colors, characters, and conditions of man. And
so we lift our gazes not to what stands between us, but what stands before us.
We close the divide because we know to put our future first. We must first put our differences aside.
We lay down our arms so we can reach out our arms to one
another. We seek harm to none and harmony for all. Let the globe, if nothing else, say this is true.
That even as we grieved, we grew. That even as we hurt, we hope. That even as we tired, we tried. They'll forever be tied together victorious.
Not because we will never again know defeat, but because we will never again sow division.
It tells us to envision that everyone shall sit under their own vine and victory, and no one shall make them afraid.
If we're to live up to our own time, then victory won't lie in the blade, but in all the bridges we've made. That is the promised glade, the hill we climb, if only we dare it.
Because being American is more than a pride we inherit. It's the past we step into and how we repair it.
We've seen a force that would shatter our nation rather than share it, would destroy our country if it meant delaying democracy. And this effort very nearly succeeded.
But while democracy can be periodically delayed, it can never be permanently defeated. In this truth, in this faith, we trust.
For while we have our eyes on the future, history has its eyes on us. This is the era of just redemption we feared at its inception.
We did not feel prepared to be the heirs of such a terrifying hour, but within it we found the power to author a new chapter, to offer hope and laughter to ourselves. So, while once we asked, how could we possibly prevail over catastrophe?
Now we assert, how could catastrophe possibly prevail over us? We will not march back to what was, but move to what shall be.
A country that is bruised, but whole, benevolent, but bold, fierce, and free.
We will not be turned around or interrupted by intimidation, because we know our inaction and inertia will be the inheritance of the next generation.
And our blunders become their burdens, but one thing is certain. If we merge mercy with might and might with right, then love becomes our legacy and change our children's birthright.
So let us leave leave behind a country better than the one we were left with. Every breath from my bronze-pounded chest, let us raise this wounded world into a wondrous
one. We will rise from the gold-limbed hills of the west. We will rise from the wind-swept northeast where our forefathers first realized revolution.
We rise from the lake-rimmed cities of the midwestern states. We will rise from the sun-baked south. We will rebuild, reconcile, and recover.
In every known nook of our nation, in every corner called our country, our people, diverse and beautiful, will emerge battered and beautiful.
When day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it.
For there is always light.
If only we were brave enough to see it. If only we were brave enough to be it.
It starts with you.
And it starts with us.
One person at a time. Our final selection is a favorite song of the young as well as the old. It is entitled "We Are the World." This song will be performed by members of the Gilchrist faculty, staff, and the entire student body of Gilchrist Elementary School.
You're down.
ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. I hope you've enjoyed our Black History Month program. It was awesome. Now we have remarks from our administration and Ms. Brown.
Good morning, everyone. I hope you have enjoyed our Black History program for 2021. It was awesome, and the kids were simply marvelous. They did such a great job. We were all over the place, but we pulled it together. I'd like to thank the administration. I'd like to thank the parents, classroom teachers, especially my special area team. And last but not least, I'd like to thank Mrs. Mendenhall, who is videotaping this and editing it and putting it all together so that you can see what these marvelous children have done. So thank you very much and have a wonderful day.